Morning guys, so finally here at Zero May, ready for the test drive and ready to meet BFG KO3. Tayo lang ata Pilipino dito, puro mga foreign. From Japan, Indonesia, Thailand, saan-saan. We're here and iramin ko lang to, papakita ko sa inyo. Here are all the delegates for today and actually for this week. And the test drive units are all set. Sasagarin ko talaga sila today guys, papakita ko sa inyo. Kung kaya natin bugbugin, bugbugin natin yung kotse, bugbugin natin yung mga gulong na yan. Let's test it. Let's not baby this babies.
Hello, Kenzo. How are you?
Good.
Thank you. Hey, you know, how are you? Good. Good to see you here.
Yeah. Thank
good.
You. Thank you.
Welcome.
Very nice to meet you.
Welcome,
Babu Kai. Babu Kai. Can you take a photo? Take us a photo.
Palacha. Palacha is a solemn dance to welcome everyone here.
It's their welcome dance, the Malacha. You know, Australia is full of their history and culture. Parang tayo lang sa Pilipinas. Let's enjoy it before we officially start the day. I-run down lang tayo sa truck para mamaya pag tayo na huwag mamaneho, mas makakabisado na natin. But we will try, marami sila mga test units. We will try one with a bumpers on it and without the bumper. So, try din natin yung baha.
You guys pumped? Excited?
Shadowies? So, there, that's the area where the mudphobic bar is working. Yeah. Just trying to release the little compacted mud. Uh-huh. So, you can see here, we're like, you can't really see anything else of the tread pattern, but we're leaving behind, and you can literally see the line where the mudphobic bar is right there. And then that serrated shoulder design, you can see it actually grabbing and trying to get traction all the way down here on this, right? Mm-hmm. And so this is, we call this our little archaeological dig, right? It's like, we want to do a little plaster of this area.
Two-wheel drive. So we're just going to do two-wheel drive to demonstrate this. So have a look how slow the car's going. And when you're in mud, if you're doing any four-wheel driving, momentum's your friend. So we're actually going to stop the momentum. Just rear wheel drive and just a little bit of acceleration.
They're
so
showing
if you
us
were to
right
walk
now,
in that, you'd slip over.
Actually, naka 4x2 lang to ngayon. So dito pinapakita nila ngayon, even a 4x2 can still perform sa mga gatong type ng terrain. And later, i-explain ko kung ano talaga yung mga, yung design, the purpose, yung mga ngipin niya. Explain ko mamaya lang.
The other two wide ones? And then we're going to get you to do it. Four-wheel drive, nice and slow. Two-wheel drive, nice and slow. Right. See how the tires work.
They tested this KO3 on a 4x2. So makikita mo, kasi pag 4x2, hindi siya gumagana yung likod. Ito yung pag nasa trail tayo minsan, kumukuha pa ako ng stick kasi we need the traction, yung mga ngipin ng tires. With a 4x2, ayan o, puno na siya ng wala ng gap, wala ng lalaban, so mag-slide na lang siya mag-slide. Pero mamaya, pag 4x4 yan, ito, pakita ko yung 4x4 ha. So ito, gumagana yung likod lang kasi 4x2 lang pinagana nila. This actually really works, ito. Yung sips ba tawag nila? So ito, pag may mud na yan dyan, tingnan nyo, hindi siya puno, hindi siya parang pancake tulad nung harap. This works, the design works kasi gumagalaw siya. Habang iniikot mo siya sa mud, kasi nag-stop pa sila kanina sa mud eh. Nung nagtumigil siya, pag roll mo ulit, pag pinatak mo muna siya ulit, gumagalaw yung line na yan. Siya yung nagtatanggal ng mga mud. So nagkakaroon ko ulit ng traction, nagkakaroon ko ulit ng ngipin. Actually, the KO2 is ginawa siya para sa mga taong technical. Parang ako, nag-offroad ako, may mga air compressor pa ako, magla-low down pa ako, tapos mag-inflate, deflate. But with this one, if you just drive and go on an overlanding, on a simple camping, it works by itself. Katrabaho na siya. So you always get the traction with the feet on the design of the tire.
Oh my God!
So we're on a 4 high again.
Yeah.
We'll try the steps on how it works.
We're just gonna go between 20 and 30 kilometers.
Okay. We'll drive slow para mas the mud will come in and we can check if it releases the mud. Try to get this mud on the tire.
Yeah.
Very easy. So that's how this KO3 works. Sometimes kasi when we're on the trail, we still need to lower down the air or increase it. But itatrabaho na siya agad, even if you're a newbie driver.
Alright, keep going around. Okay. No, keep going up there again. One more? Yeah.
Okay.
Whoa.
Getting too excited. Hi guys, so we are out here the whole day in the terrain, in the trail, trying to experience different types of terrain. Gravel, mud, dry mud, wet mud, iba-iba. Low speed, high speed, anything. But hindi lang natin matatry ngayon is the snow, but this is an all-terrain tire. So lahat papatry it sa atin, and we are very blessed to learn more of this and experience more of this. Hindi lang siya yung regular tire. We understand deeper the design and all the details. Kanina we were explained with the sipes, but this one, ito yung parang 3D pattern sa tread nila. Napin ko lang. Parang ito. Lahat yan, all of this has a purpose. Ito yung parang tread wear niya, ano yung purpose. Like this one. Well, alam naman natin yun, the BFG, yung mold niya is mababa. To give way na ito, functional lahat. Kasi yung ibang mga tire, dito lang yun eh. Dito lang yung design. But this one, when you go low with air pressure, this become part of your tire. And this is what's nice with the KO3. Yung compound of the KO3 is different from this and this. Yung higher race cars nila, Michelin, ito yung ginamit. Kasi BFG and Michelin is just one company. So, yung race compound, mas mataas tong side na to. So, even if you go low PSI, nakausap ko nga kanina si Brandon, yung engineers, one of mga nag-design nitong tires na to. This tire actually is a collaboration. Lahat pinakinggan nila, upgraded KO2, of course. So, lahat ng mga reklamo, lahat ng ikakaganda, that's how they come up with this tire. And it's a 5-year development. Like this one, parang dito ko lang nalaman ngayon, this designs, ito yung sipes kanina, yung pinakita ko, na gumagalaw siya to release the mud para hindi siya nag-stack dyan. Kasi usually, di ba, pag nasa trail ako, minsan nagaganon-ganon pa ako ng stick kasi punong-puno ng mud. But with this one, it helps na pag may tire na siya, nagkakaroon siya ng traction, gumagalaw siya, nare-release niya yung mud. And then this one naman, pag heavy load ka, lalo na naman kung snow or sobrang bigat, kulang ka sa yung ngipin mo, maninipis, mahina eh, kasi hindi ka solid. But you can come as one solid tire pag mabigat ka. Ayan oh. Yun oh. It becomes one solid teeth. How amazing the engineering of the KO3. Tapos, ito ha, it's an all-terrain tire. It's not the KM3 mud terrain or other brands. This is an all-terrain with an aggressive look. And then this one, this KO3 is already awarded by a Baja champion performance. So mataas talaga yung specification niya on an all-terrain. And of course, sa lahat ng clients natin na ayaw yung maingay, this is the perfect tire for you. Less noise but with aggressiveness, more advanced than the KM3.
So this is all about experiencing the traction in regards to braking.
Okay.
How well the car brakes, mm-hmm. And the braking properties of the KO3. So very impressive. So We'll do a lap around and we'll stop on the track hole, and then I'll explain what we're going to do.
So you heard, guys, tatry naman natin ngayon yung braking and stopping power ng KO3 mismo. So we'll not depend more on the braking and the engine. The tire itself, it helps you brake. And we're on a 4x4, it's a Mazda BT50. So let's give it a try.
So in a minute, what we'll do is from the start, we'll accelerate fast. There's a cone down there on the side. I'm going to say brake, and when I say brake, full ABS stop, and stop the car as quick as you can. Want to feel the car actually, feel that tire actually gripping the road. It's very impressive the way it works. So anyway,
we're really going to challenge the tire.
Yeah, we're going to challenge the tire. As you heard through Brandon's explanation and Beltran, one of the big upsides of the new KO3 is the braking distance is braking performance is
so we'll give it a hard try. We have already experienced the KO2, of course, the KM3, and then the KO3 now. Paano siya yung stopping the braking?
Probably...
Hindi tayo nag-slide ng mahabang-mahaba ah. Nag-pull paddle ako ah. Metal paddle.
Maybe pulled up in about 18 meters.
Yes.
From 60 k's an hour.
Impressive. Very impressive. We are on our second leg for today. We'll try different terrain. The shale hills, water rocks, rock garden, and slippery slopes. Titingnan natin yung mga grip and paano kumagat yung mga tread ni KO3. So,
so I've got all this 75mm concrete chip, so just to simulate the bar hard sharp rocks, and then flat out all the way around here, then a hard on the brakes of the bird. Feel the tyres just biting in, you're giving that confidence that you can steer the car in. Then patient as you come around, and then on the gas, and it feels like you're on a bitumen road. The weight just pushes you back. Then hard on the brakes here, a nice off-camber slide. Let the flat come around, and then nose the point. So just giving total confidence in the tyres. Then another off-camber corner, and then just trying to get the grip and go.
Yeah!
KO3, go!
The power is there! Oh God! KO3 really performs on the trail. This is actually my kind of Disneyland, guys. Riding with a pro driver here. Woo! Damn. Ooh, sarap. Say sarap.
Once you're ready, we'll head down that way.
Okay. I'll just take a quick video. We are on a 4-low, tapos naka-on yung hill descent natin. We'll try different terrain, especially the toughness of the sidewall of the KO3. Let's put it into test.
So I'll head down here over those sort of offset.
Can I go 100 on this one? No, I'm just kidding.
Oh, someone's tried before, don't worry. We're going to take these cars back in the same condition we picked them up.
Okay. Try natin siyang patakboy ng mag-isa kasi naka-heel descent naman.
That's it.
Little bit of bumpy left and right. There you go.
That's it, just keep it straight. Just nice and slow. There we go.
Easy. Sundan dahan-dahan tayo kasi sa Pilipinas sinahataw natin.
Stop at the top of this one.
Okay. Then just let it go.
Yep. That's it. Saving that, what's that? About 16 degrees.
Yeah.
By 8, it goes to 20. Yeah. Plenty of traction, and even try and do this just nice and slow.
Release na ako ng gas pababa. Mag-descent naman.
Yeah, so go out nice and wide, because this one is quite a sharp corner. A little bit wider.
way.
Yeah.
Sweet. Now start to turn in.
That's it. Start to spin.
Keep going. Yeah, yeah.
Especially when going up, I was expecting wheel speed.
Yeah, we've got an even steeper hill around the corner.
Yeah, we did experience that.
Yeah. If you want to stop again, if you don't, you can just keep on going. It's an impressive climb though.
Mm-hmm.
Especially at wheel speed. It's
spunky door. I'm not going to get the hill. Tested. Totoo. Hindi kwento-kwento lang.
All the cars out there.
Oh.
Well, we're taking a lot of terrains to test the KO3s, but later, the most used in the Philippines, it's on the road, so we'll try the noise also on how quiet it is.
It's pretty incredible. I mean, obviously with the new tires.
This is a 2-week event, right? Yes. So you haven't changed the tires since then?
No.
Okay, so we are on our last lap. Finally, we are gonna test the KO3 on the road. Mostly, I wanna feel the steering, the handling, and the noise, of course. So let's go. It's 160 to 180, right?
60
to 180.
I like that. That was good. That's good value.
Okay. Mostly KM3 look siya. Yeah, even the spikes is malalaki. But as I've explained kanina, iba-iba yung pattern niya. So you can really hear na mas tahimik siya. Although, syempre malakas yung hangin dito. Pero overall, tahimik. I won't talk more. I want you to listen, guys. So, para ma-check yung mga. So, nilagay namin siya sa neutral, coded dead, para mas makita nyo patay yung makina, even the aircon is less noise. Yun narinig nyo talaga kung ano lang si KO3. But definitely, we'll do a test drive din sa mga demo units namin dyan. Paparinig namin kung ano talaga yung performance. Even with the steering, hindi siya malikot. Ayan, wala siyang nginig. Nothing at all. Okay. Thanks, bro. Tahimik lang dito. Maganda rin kasi yung daan. Pag, pag naingayan kayo dyan sa Pilipinas, daan na natin yung sira-sira. It's very quiet.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Great day, well, a perfect day with an Australian beer, with this kind of food. It's just perfect. Acoustic, it's just perfect. Well, again, thank you, endless thank you to BFGoodrich, and very excited to have the KO3 in the Philippines. I have actually sobra. Papa English na ako. I have actually a full list on what I learned and I wanna share sa atin, but I'll do a different video na lang. But again, thank you very much BFG and to Team Ride Max. Thank you very much Kenzo, salamat sobra. But yeah, I hope na-explain ko maayos dyan sa video kung ano yung mga technicalities, what are the positivity of the product, and kung ano ba yung medyo nakulangan pa ako. Well, actually, wala eh. Kasi kung meron man, yung hindi ko na lang na-try is the snow trail, which is wala naman sa atin sa Pilipinas, so it doesn't really matter. So, yun. Overall, a good thumbs up to all these who organized the event, and the KO3 is gonna be a game changer for sure. Not just in the Philippines, but the whole world. Sobrang ganda ng technology, sobrang ganda ng performance. Well, again, thank you very much and goodbye.